It's requested a few times, and I mean, I know I like watching these videos from other people as well, so totally understandable. But this is what I came up with in this video. Like always, I just kind of went in without a plan and decided to wing it. Take everything I say with a grain of salt. I do not claim to be a makeup expert of any kind, but if you want to take a few ideas from this video, that would be cool. I go through step by step what I used and how I used it. And I know my last makeup video was literally the last video, but I had someone else doing my makeup in that video, so this will be a little bit different. And this will not be a voiceover, so it's a little bit different, going for a little bit of a different look. And this is a much more like chill vibe, just kind of talking with you and chatting with you while I do my makeup and kind of narrate what I'm doing. So without further ado, let's get into the video and see how I did this to my face. So the very first thing to do is actually, I never do this and I need to start doing it. I'm just gonna put my hair back. I found this headband in my mom's bathroom. I haven't worn one of these since like middle school. Anyway, whatever, just so I get no makeup in my face or anything. Now, the next thing that I'm gonna do is I have really bad smile lines that you basically get from smiling and laughing. They're like wrinkles, basically. And I get a lot of foundation creasing in there. So I like to, this is the little trick that I found. I take some like face lotion and I put it right over where the smile line is. And I just completely cover that. You don't want too much, like you don't want it like completely soaked in lotion. Some mattifying, kind of like translucent powder. It's from Wet n Wild. I don't use this anymore except for this, so I have like a very little bit left, and I'm just gonna take my ring finger, put a little bit on there, and cover right where I put the lotion. My skin's sensitive, so it's gonna make it look a little red. Also, yesterday I had a really bad allergic reaction to a new lotion that my friend gave me, Joanya, from a few videos ago. I tried a new lotion yesterday that Joanya gave me, and I was very much allergic to it. I had little tiny bumps, and it was red all over my mouth. It was only around my mouth. It was the weirdest thing. It's much better now, but you could still see like some of the redness. So if you're wondering why it's so red there, that's why. But yeah, it's much better today, thank goodness. Okay, so the next thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my e.l.f. color correcting sticks. I have two of them. One of them is this orangey peach color, and the other one is green. Now, this orangey peach color is for correcting dark spots. I have a lot of discoloration under and around my eyes because your girl doesn't sleep as much as she should. So I put it like that. Most people don't put it on their eyelids, but I do. And then I'm just gonna put it on any like dark spots or scarring that I have. And I have quite a bit from, you know, the damage that acne leaves. But I think that's it. Yeah, years of acne can do a number on your skin. I don't really get like acne too bad anymore, but the remnants of it are still very much there. And then the green one is for any red spots, blemishes, like what I have around my nose and around my mouth. This redness gotta go. And when I was buying this, it was funny, I bought it at CVS. And This is a pretty full coverage foundation. Now, a little disclaimer, because I know someone's gonna point it out to me. This foundation is a little bit too light for me, but I used it for the first time yesterday, and I was able to fix that with bronzer and contour and blush and all that, so it will be my dad too. He was like, wow, you look nice. And I was like, thank you. I guess I don't look nice every other day, but it's fine. So yeah, before anybody says anything, it's too light on me. I know. I'm gonna look like a ghost real quick. But it's fine. So I'm in the shade, by the way, 310. 3.10. And it's cool. I have never ordered foundation online before, or really any makeup online, for this very reason, because I am horrible at picking foundation colors, like, in the store. So I was like, if I can't do it in person, I'm not gonna be able to do it online. But this was, you guys probably know this, some of you, but it was new to me. They have a foundation matcher online, so you like put in the foundation that you're currently wearing, like the brand and the shade, and then it matches you with the same color in this foundation. So I thought that that was really cool. It obviously didn't really work 100%, but it got something pretty close, because I honestly had no idea which one I was gonna be. And I do have to be kind of careful, because you can still see like the bumps from the allergic reaction, and I don't want it to look geeky. I mean, it's going to a little bit if you're like really up in my face, like studying my face. Just 'cause there's no way around that. The bumps just have to go away naturally. Bring it down my neck so your girl is all even. And look at that. Like, I almost feel like I don't need concealer. I mean, I'm gonna use concealer, but like, just the color correcting and everything, it's amazing. If you have like redness and dark circles and whatever, and you don't like using pounds of concealer, I highly, highly recommend color correcting beforehand. And it's so cheap, $5 each. Okay, I'm gonna go in with my Tarte Shape Tape. I am in the shade Light. And again, like, I don't need a lot now, but I'm gonna put a little V there. And a little V there. And a little V there. And there. Basically just, oh, I don't wanna put a lot on my chin, actually, because that's where all the gross skin is right now. And that's literally all I'm gonna do. That's it. Also, anyone who uses this, like, I love this, because it really is, like, full coverage, and it's really good for, like, highlighting the high points of your face. But does anyone notice that it gets so dirty? Like, look at this. The other day, I had to take everything out of my makeup bag and wipe everything down with a makeup wipe, because it gets on everything, and it just, like, builds up right here. I don't know if that's just me, but it's really annoying. Like, I almost just don't want to put it in my makeup bag. Like, when I'm home and I'm not traveling, I keep it out on my dresser, because it's ridiculous. So I'm going in with my same damp beauty blender, and I'm just working that all in. Also, I mean, obviously you guys can imagine that I'm looking down at my mirror, but I'm sorry that I feel like I'm looking like all the way down. I had to lower the mirror a little bit so that the mirror wasn't like in the camera shot. So one of my other friends just found out about my channel this morning. She sent me a screenshot of my channel, so you know who you are. If you're watching, hello. It's Tuesday morning, by the way. I don't know when this is gonna go up, but if you found out about my channel Tuesday morning and you're watching, hello. I love you. But anyway, okay, so that's pretty much. So even though my foundation's kind of light, at least the concealer is lighter and it works with the high points of my face. So now, I'm using a few of the tricks that Kathy taught me when she did my makeup. I don't have, like, translucent setting powder. And she was asking me, like, when she was doing my face, she was like, so how do you set your under eyes? wonder is really the way to go. Took me a long time to realize it, but here we are. And then for the rest of the face, I'm just gonna lightly, I don't like putting a lot of powder because I'm not that oily and I don't want like dry looking skin. I'm just gonna very lightly, that's it, just dust the rest of my face with the powder. So now to bring some life back into my face, I'm going to get my, oh no, it's back here, one moment. I thought I brought everything, but I guess I didn't. And a tiny bit down my nose. That's actually a lot, but whatever. And a little bit on my jawline. That's it. And then I'm gonna take my $2 beauty sponge from Primark. And I'm just gonna, this is not damp. Go with it, and I'm just going to lightly blend that in. I would rather go lighter with the contour and then darken it up if I need to with the bronzer, just because I feel like this dark concealer is really scary because it's really dark. And then crazy to define that collarbone a little bit. Collarbone. Jawline. It's okay, I'm okay. Don't worry about me. This is like the hardest beauty blender ever. Like, it is literally a rock. It's so hard. But whatever. As you can see, like, you can barely see it on camera. But it comes to life with the bronzer in a second. Why isn't this blending? Okay. Like, I literally put barely anything. And then buff that in on my nose. Yeah, see, I put a tiny bit too much, but I can fix that. Okay. So that's all I do for that. And then I'm gonna take my ish contour kit in the light medium-ish shade. And it comes with a highlighter, a blush, and two bronzers. And I'm gonna take a combination of the two and just go right over. Doing. Wow, that's actually not bad. I'm normally really bad at this. But I'm basically just sculpting my face, giving it a little bit of definition. I wonder if you can pick up the brush sounds because the mic is literally right there. You can't see it, but it's right there. Smile lines are still coming through my trick didn't work today. If anybody has like a trick of how you kind of work around your smile eyes when it comes to makeup, please share them with me, because like during the day I literally feel myself like smoothing out my makeup with my fingers, which is really bad. You don't want that, because then you like literally take off your makeup. So help me. Honestly, there might not be anything I can do, but okay, so that's it for the contouring. I think I'm gonna go over this a little bit. This makes your face look all more. Wrinkles to have, right? Happy lines mean, or smile lines mean that you're happy. Okay, so I'm gonna go in and do my brows now. I still use my NYX eyebrow cake powder and my little brush. It's an Ardell brush. I bought it on Amazon. It's a spoolie on one end and a brush on the other. I'm gonna dip into the lightest shade. With my eyebrows, I don't try to give them a new shape, nothing like that. I just go with the natural shape. And fun fact, I think I've mentioned this in a video before, but in case you've never watched any of my makeup videos before, I have never gotten my eyebrows done. As you saw before, I have very light eyebrows. Inner corners of my brows. Don't ask me why, I just think it looks better when I use this. It comes out a little more like natural looking. Oh yeah, I need to trim the tops of them, but I don't think you can really tell on camera. So yeah. Be the first to admit that my eyebrows are like not twins or sisters, they're like cousins, like removed, like once removed cousins, but whatever. Okay, so now what do I do? My eyes. I don't use eyeshadow primer, I'm sorry. So I'm gonna go in from Elf. And I'm gonna let me use a different palette. I'm gonna go in with, let me see. Let me compare colors real quickly. I'm gonna go with my ish one. And I'm gonna use this shimmery color right there in the corner. It's like a literally like a copper. And it has gold specks in it. And I'm gonna just pack that. Oh, I forgot, with these ish palettes, you really need to like pack it onto your brush. And I'm gonna just pack that right onto my like whole eyelid. It gives it a little bit of a different color. Hear her right now. She's literally groaning because she can't get comfortable. I think she found another position. Alright. Do I leave it like that? I leave it like that. I'm gonna put, though, a little bit on my lower line. Where the heck did I put that palette? I'm going to take this shade down here and put it right underneath my lash line. So like a very little bit. I don't really like putting a lot underneath, as I've told you guys a million times. That's all I'm gonna do. Okay. So next, I need to put on my eyeliner. I'm not gonna line my under eyes, I don't think. Not today. Oh my goodness, my eyeliner is stuck under my computer and I can't get it out. Okay. So I use my Tarte Sex Kitten. So if you want them to look relatively even, then you have to line them a little bit differently. So they look a little more symmetric. If that makes sense. Alright, so that's fine to me. Some false lashes on today, which I don't think I've ever done in a video, so first time. But you do want to put on regular mascara. This is the L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise. Oh no, I was gonna curl them, but I didn't bring my curler, so never mind. But that's fine, because I'm putting the fake lashes on, so
I did forget to do something, but I'll do it right now after I do this.
This pen. It's by Thrive Cosmetics and it's the Brilliant Eye Brightener. Looks like this. You can also put this, I'll put a little bit. It's not basically a highlighting stick. I should have just done this. This is so much easier. And then in my inner corners, just to brighten up the eye. Don't put a lot, because See why people use lip liners. Yep, this is good.